Is a huge New Kids fan.
How heartthrob Donnie Wahlberg balances Blue Bloods, New Kids, and his own two kids.
I cannot be on tour dancing around with New Kids and Backstreet Boys and be a grandfather.
Today, an hour of what's hot right now. First,
who here is a huge New Kids fan?
That would be fun.
Donnie Wahlberg on everything from New Kids to Blue Bloods to Hangin' Toughest Dad.
Glad to have the talk with him because I cannot be on tour dancing around and be a grandfather, so you have to behave yourself.
Then,
surprises, especially when we get to surprise our viewers. Take a look back at one of the greatest moments for us of season 3 of our show. Huge surprise. Watch.
Jordan is my favorite. This is his water bottle that I've kept all this time.
Oh, honey, hug it out. Are you okay?
I'm fine, Rachel. Okay, to make a long story short, I've had this for 15 years. Until yesterday, there was water in it. At the airport, he made me.
Oh! Here, stand next to me.
Oh my God.
Up, Angie. Up, because I'm sitting in front of us.
Show one of the boys, singer, and what an actor, Donnie Wahlberg. Donnie, look great. Welcome back. I banged my leg up, so I'm kind of gonna look. I'm gonna look crazy getting in the chair here. Nice to see you again. You look fantastic.
Me too.
You look younger than last time. What are you taking? Can I have some?
I'm following your recipes. And
thanks for the plug.
I just had some pasta backstage and.
It is pretty good food here, right?
Yeah. You look great, too, by the way.
Thank you.
I know you're married.
I've been running around.
You're very lovely. I'm a fan.
I mean, we saw just that moment from years ago. I mean, the fan reaction still to this day. But now the 2011 tour is with the Backstreet Boys and the New Kids. I mean, double threat. You guys are going to have some deep security.
Yeah, well, you know, we're okay with security. I don't think we worry about that stuff too much. It's one of the good things about doing music again after all these years is the little girls who used to, like, grab and rip our clothes off and pull our hair, they've grown up into women, and they're
nice. You think they're going to act any better?
They scream. Well, yeah, I think it's like they get it. It's like concert time. You know, bumping to you backstage. Hi, how you doing? I work for this company, and this is what I do, and I'm mature now. And they buy their tickets on their own credit cards and not their parents. It's a different thing.
It's trippy, though, right?
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's great.
It is fantastic, and to see the fans come back and be so excited and be that same level.
Yeah, it's been amazing. I mean, the reunion that New Kids did in 08 was just unbelievable. And you know what was really the best thing about it? A lot of people don't quite get it, but when you're in a boy band or a teenage group, you know, people kind of write it off because the fans are little girls and they think, you know, oh, what do they know?
They don't
really know.
Seriously.
But having seen these women grow up and have children and husbands who are fighting in Iraq and all these different things, you know, we heard so many stories of how, you know, us coming back together gave, you know, a lot of women who now have 9-to-5s and these very hectic lives a chance to feel young and free again and to live, this sort of thing. It was really very profound experience.
You just made goosebumps on me. You know, I want you to know, I can't believe Xavier's 17.
Yeah.
Kids are 17 and 9 now.
I have a 17-year-old.
It's crazy.
I know, and he's
got
a girlfriend. I'm not supposed to talk about him on TV, but he's got a girlfriend. And, you know, so I had to have the talk with him because I said, I cannot be on tour dancing around with New Kids and Backstreet Boys and be a grandfather. So you have to behave yourself. You have to behave. Yeah, but he's like 6'2". He's amazing. He's very out of the spotlight, though. He's my 9-year-old Elijah. Any New Kids fans have probably seen him on stage. Yeah. He comes on stage a lot and sings, and he's like me. He's like.
So he's got the bug, then?
Well, it's weird. He's got the bug, but he doesn't. You know, he has it when he wants it. He's very moody. He's one of those.
Turn it on, turn it off.
He turns it on and turns it off. I tell everybody, don't take it personal if he doesn't speak to you for the first 4 or 5 times you meet him. But he loves to go on stage, and he came out on tour during one of the summer tours, and he said, Dad, I want to come out and sing on Step by Step. I want to sing Step 5. And I was like, why Step 5? He said, well, because John's my favorite new kid. And so he started singing Step 5, and I would say, you know, Jordan would be playing the keyboards in the dressing room. I said, you got to practice. Jordan is going to play it, and you practice. He said, no, I don't practice, Dad. I just go out and do it. And it's great. It's really sweet.
He sounds really cool.
He's fun, but he just got straight A's on his report card.
Yeah! Fourth grade,
I think he's had one B in his 4 years of
that
school.
Is fantastic.
Yeah, it makes me very proud.
Big brain, too. Fantastic. Yeah, yeah. Good job. Yeah. What are they listening to? Do you keep up with what their faves are?
Well, again, my older son, I'm not going to say his name because he'll get mad at me if he happens to see this, but he's in a band. He's actually in a band. But they play very dark, you know, hardcore music and mosh pits and the whole thing. He always is coming home, you know, he's got the big earrings with the holes
gauges,
in his ear.
Gauges.
Yeah. And he's always like, yeah, Dad, I had this awesome show. It's cool because he's my son and we love each other. We have a great relationship, but it's like we don't talk about like, Dad, the bully at school said this to me. It's like, yeah, Dad, I was in the mosh pit and it was awesome. And this chick jumped on my head and punched me. And it's really cool, you know. And Elijah, he doesn't listen to a lot of music per se. He's into like a lot of the Disney shows, which is really sweet because I get to watch, you know, Wizards of Waverly Place. And
so your kids are keeping you current in very different ways.
In different ways, but it's cool, you know. It's funny to hear my 9-year-old sort of talk about like, Mom, I don't like Justin Bieber, Dad. All the girls like him. It's funny because, you know, that's what the little boys used to say about my band, you know, all those years ago.
And that's true, right?
Yeah, it's cool.
Now, you've played a cop before, but now you're in Blue Bloods, and one of our favorite other guests, Tom Selleck. What a great guy.
He's the best.
You got a great cast in this show.
Yep.
Part of a family situation. You must be very comfortable with that because you come from such a big family.
Yeah, I mean, you know, one of the things people love about the show is these dinner scenes that we do, and we could use some of your food, by the way, for the dinner scenes.
I'll prop it out.
Because I eat, you know, when we shoot the dinner scenes, I actually eat the food, and Tom's always looking over at me in between takes. He's like, dude, why don't you stop eating? You don't have to eat this awful food. And it's like, I know, but I like to stay in the moment,
in the
Tom.
Character, in the moment. Right.
But the dinner scenes are really something that's really resonated with a lot of people.
And it makes it different than other cop shows. I'm a cop show junkie. So
yeah.
I love that bringing in that extra element, that extra layer.
Yeah, it's fun, and the family stuff is really what drew me to the part. When I read the script originally, I thought about my sister and I. We had 9 kids at the dinner table, and it was very chaotic and arguments, and everyone would sort of air out all their stuff. And I read the script, and I didn't picture Bridget Moynihan, which she's, believe me, she's much better to look at than my sister, but looking across from her. No.
I'll edit that out.
No, listen. So my sister's going to kill me. I didn't mean it like that. My sister's beautiful, but when I'm arguing with her, believe me, I do not want to see her face. She goes there. She goes to the dark side.
My mom's 1 of 10. We all know in our family what it's like being around a crammed kitchen table, too. Let's take a look at a clip from Blue Bloods. Watch.
CSU puts a shooter somewhere out in the street. Eyewitnesses?
We got about a couple of dozen people trying to get into the club, but everybody's looking this way.
All right, so shots ring out, everybody scrambles, plus they're all drunk. By the time they get their bearings, our shooter's in the wind.
Almost like you've done this before, Detective.
Yeah, once or twice.
So nobody's eyes are working. What about their ears?
Witnesses confirm hearing one shot. Vic caught it in the neck.
I see one eyeball that wasn't snockered.
Anyone here from the club we can talk to?
Owner's right over there.
Sabrina Glick, she owns this place?
Well, you know her?
No, not really. Just what I read about her. She's a Page 6 staple. You'd like her. She only comes out at night.
Fantastic. So, you guys film here in the city, yeah?
Yep.
So what are some of your favorite New York haunts from filming here? Any great New York moments or favorite burger?
There's always a New York
moment. Yeah, exactly.
I can't tell you my favorite burger because I was told backstage you'll get mad at me. It's fast food, so I know. I heard you make the greatest burgers.
Well, I am the self-proclaimed queen of burgers. I am.
All right. I know I keep throwing it. I don't mean to embarrass you, but, you know, I watch you. I've watched you for a long time. So I'm going to keep, anytime
that.
You mention food, I'm going to say Rachael
Gosh.
Ray. Yeah, it's like, believe me, the EVOO, the whole nine.
I'll make you a burger anytime.
There you go.
So I'm going to take a quick break, but up next, the audience is going to get in on this. They're going to do a little Q&A. Right after a huge 2011 tour. We've been chatting, but we wanted to let everybody else here get in on it too. But I got 2 more quick ones. I hear that you're actually working the musical skills into the script, for real?
A little bit. They presented me with this script where my character comes in, and he's singing in the car, and he goes to a nightclub to investigate a murder, and he starts dancing with this girl, and they were like, we want you to really, like, pull out all your old moves, and I was like, come on, man. It's a little different. So I had to play the character's old moves, not my old
moves. Your old moves.
Yeah, but they're fun.
I can't wait, though, right? Talk about must-see TV.
It'll be fun.
So, and I also wanted to know, do you get your chops busted at all on the set? For being a new kid, you know, does anybody come
not really.
The music or razzing you or anything?
Not really. I'm finding sort of now that, except for Tom. Tom Selleck is, you know, he was not a closet New Kids fan 20 years ago. I can assure you of that. But he's great. He razzes me about other stuff, but never the music stuff. I think what I find now is a lot of people were sort of fans, and a lot of, you know, I get a lot of guys now. A lot of the crew guys go, you know.
I gotta admit,
you guys, well, it's more with the New York accents. You're Don, I gotta tell you. You guys, you was okay. No posters, but you was okay.
I love it. All right, where's Rebecca? Rebecca's gonna go first. Yes, Rebecca, pop on up.
Hi. My name's Rebecca. I gotta tell you, I'm a big fan. When I was younger, my girlfriend and I used to fantasize that we were your backup dancers. And we would dance around our bedrooms with hairbrushes, pretending to, you know, we were backstage with you guys. But I was wondering, now that it's so many years later and you guys are back on tour, how has conversations changed now that you're all grown up?
I think we talk about our kids come out, you know, we talk about a lot of different stuff, but what's really making it fun now is working with Backstreet Boys together with New Kids. It's amazing to see how different a journey we had from them, but how many similarities there are, you know. Nick Carter tells stories that sound like our Joe McIntyre stories, you know, because they were the little guys, and it's really amazing to be doing this with those guys and sort of have, you know, someone else who has a similar experience, you know. It's when you're that successful, it's a whirlwind, you know, and it's hard to find other people who can understand what you've been through, and
we can relate.
When we look in their eyes, we kind of see, it's like, you get it, you get it, and you know, it really makes it fun. Yeah.
Where are you, Kate?
Oh, hi, Kate. I'm Kate. I was wondering, can we look forward to any collaborations with your brother in the future?
That would be fun. I think Mark and I have always talked about working together, you know, and looking for the perfect project for us. I think, you know, for both of us, it was important to establish ourselves separately.
Yeah.
You know, in the music business, I helped him, and it's sort of a known story that, you know, that I helped him get his start. But with acting, I think he wanted to separate himself from his music, you know, name, and I wanted to have my own acting career, you know. So we've really taken separate paths. But I think in time, if the right project comes along, we'll certainly, we'll keep an eye open.
It's certainly been long enough now, you know, you've been a couple of really huge series and stuff. Yeah. We have time for one more. Taryn, am I saying that right? Hi, Taryn.
Hi, I'm Taryn. I was wondering, the holidays are coming up at the end of the month, so are you good at cooking, good in the kitchen, and are you good at giving gifts?
Why are you
like everybody else?
I'm good at giving gifts. I'm useless in the kitchen. No cooking for me. I'll call like a caterer or somebody, or just go to my mom's house. My mother's a great cook. But with gifts, I've always been a big giver, you know. It may sound sappy, but I'm that guy that, like, I don't want gifts at Christmas time. I just want to give. Like, I love to see people's faces.
When they open,
you know, when they
up.
Open something up. And I get embarrassed opening gifts up myself. So.
I know. It's,
yeah.
That's so true. If you're that person, that's the gift for you, and you feel all weird opening your own.
Yeah.
We hope you have very happy holidays. Thanks for coming back and seeing us.
Thank you.
Blue Bloods, of course, airs Fridays on CBS. Friday nights, CBS. Be right back. In a few, there